So in this episode, we're going to dive into the world of just-in-time manufacturing. In the previous episode in the series, we talked about inventory management, but here we're going to talk about JIT or just-in-time. We're going to learn how a strategy revolutionized production while minimizing waste, reducing lead time, and improving efficiency. Hello, my supply chain people. I'm Professor Rodriguez, your college instructor and supply chain executive. And today in our Supply Chain Management Explained in 10 Minutes series, we're going to take a little look into the world of just-in-time manufacturing. I talk about what it is, what are its core principles, and how it can revolutionize your business. So what do you say? Stay tuned and let's unlock some of the secrets of just-in-time manufacturing in under 10 minutes. So let's start with the basics. Just-in-time manufacturing is like a finely tuned engine for a business. It's a production strategy where goods are produced precisely when they're needed, neither too early nor too late, in order to meet customer demand. So now let's break down the core principles of just-in-time manufacturing. First, we have the pull system. Instead of pushing products into the market based on forecast, just-in-time relies on customer demand to pull products through the production process. It's like when baking a fresh batch of cookies, only when someone asks for them. Second, there's waste reduction. Just-in-time is all about eliminating waste, whether it's excess inventory, overproduction, or inefficient processes. It's like Marie Kondoing your whole supply chain because you keep only what you truly want and only what truly sparks joy. Third is continuous improvement. Just-in-time encourages constant improvement in processes. This means finding and fixing any bottlenecks, reducing setup times, and fine-tuning operations for maximum efficiency. Now let's explore the benefits of just-in-time manufacturing. Well, first up is efficiency. By producing only what's needed, when it's needed, just-in-time reduces excess inventory. It saves storage cost and also allows for better capital flow. Another one is lower cost. Waste reduction leads to cost savings. We're wasting less, therefore we're saving more. Companies spend less on raw materials, less on storage space, and of course, less on labor. We also have higher quality. With fewer defects and a focus on continuous improvement, just-in-time often leads to higher quality products, which keeps customers happy. Now let's take a look at some real-world examples of companies that have embraced the just-in-time manufacturing strategy and the impact it's had. Perhaps the most famous example I can bring you is Toyota. Toyota pioneered the just-in-time manufacturing system. They focused on reducing waste, improving quality, and responding quickly to customer demand. The result? Well, Toyota has become one of the world's largest automakers, and this is mostly thanks to the just-in-time management system. Another example is McDonald's, because even fast food giants like McDonald's used just-in-time principles. They prepare food only when it's ordered, minimizing food waste and ensuring customers get fresh meals. In the fashion industry, another example would be Zara. Zara is known for its rapid response to trends. They produce small quantities of a wide variety of designs and restock based on actually what sells. This reduces excess inventory and they can stay on top of fashion trends as they happen. So there you have it. This was just a little brief overview of just-in-time manufacturing. Now, whether you're a business owner, a student, or simply interested in supply chain management, understanding what is just-in-time can really help you transform the way that you approach production and inventory management in general. If you found this information valuable, please hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on more insights in supply chain management. Well, I want to thank you all for joining me today. I'll see you in the next episode of our series, Supply Chain Management Explained in 10 Minutes. Until then, keep those production lines running efficiently and keep the supply chains running smoothly. And keep learning about supply chain and logistics and much more in our channel with us. All right, so I'll see you in the next time. Bye.